I created this little sieve out of some scrap wood and some hardware fabric. And what we're gonna do is we're just gonna push through the peat moss, because when you get it from the store, you get all these twigs and stuff that you don't want in your soil blocks. Now when you're done passing all your peat moss through the sieve, you're gonna get a bunch of sticks and twigs and stuff. What I do with them is I give them to my worm bin, and my worms compost them for me. So now that you've sifted everything, you should have a nice fine product like this. And that's what we're gonna mix to make soil blocks. Time to mix it up. So we got, this one is the peat that we just sieved. So put 1 5-gallon bucket of that in there. Okay. Then this one is the compost, and we put 1 5-gallon bucket of that in there. Now the compost I got at a local place called Green Cow in Dublin, Texas. I used them last year and this year, and the product is very good. So we're not sponsored, but I'm just saying the product's good. Half a bucket of Pearlite. The reason I use half a bucket, a lot of people, there's a million recipes out there, but a lot of people just use a bucket, a bucket, and a bucket. But I also add some pre-mixed potting soil from a company out in California called Fox Farms. And their stuff already has some Pearlite in it. So if I add a whole bucket of Pearlite, when I'm gonna make my soil blocks, it will not fold together or congeal or whatever you call it. All the stuff is dry right now, so we're gonna add some water, and then I do have some amendments we're gonna add in a second. I'll show you those. Now we're gonna add our fertility. I got a little bit of blood meal there. I add a teaspoon per gallon of soil. And then I also do bone meal. On that, I also add a teaspoon per gallon of soil. And then this is a product called azomite. It's a powdered rock dust, and it just adds minerals to the soil. So we're gonna add that in. So before we add some water, we're gonna just mix this in a little bit. My wife likes to tell me how bad the blood meal smells, but it's good for the plants and they like it. So high in nitrogen, and helps them. Nitrogen helps with green plant growth. So when they're babies, that's the most important part, is the green growth when they get going. Now that you got all your ingredients incorporated, we need to add some water to this. If you get a nice handful of it and squeeze, there should be some water that comes out, but we'll show you how that works. It's actually kind of amazing how much water it does take sometimes. I'm starting out with a 5-gallon bucket. And we'll see where we get. So that's 2 gallons right there. We'll mix that up and then I'll get back to you. I got this mixed up. It took every bit of that 5 gallons, and it looks like it's a good consistency now. You got a little bit of water dripping out, and it'll hold together. Now that we've got our masonry tub filled up, we're going to start soil blocking. So the one that we got has 35 1-inch holes, and when you fill a tray, it'll do
105 blocks.
What we do to load it up, we press it down in here, give it a twist until it gets down to the bottom of the tray, and it kind of scrapes off like that at the bottom of the tray. And you lift it out. I like to kick it up against the edge for my first one. You're gonna press down on the top, give it some weight, and then I just, with pressure, pull up, pull it off, and there you got 35 nice soil blocks. Second one, we'll go in and do the same thing. And I like to line that up against the other edge of the tray. Give it a push on top. Pull up. I'm good. And then every once in a while, I gotta look up here. Just give it a rinse. Blocks get nice and full. You don't have enough soil in there, there's air pockets. That's when they tend to crumble on you. At least for me they do. Last one, I try and get it in the middle. And there you go. So now we're gonna plant our soil blocks. Today we got magenta, which is a summer crisp lettuce. It does well in the heat of the summer. Pop those in. The ones I got are pelleted. You don't have to get them pelleted, but they're a lot easier to deal with. I was actually going to use my seeder and just direct seed these, but I find that I end up having to spend a lot of time going back through and thinning them. And this way, I don't have to thin them. I can just plant them once and I'm done. Today, we're also going to be planting Nevada, which is also a summer crisp lettuce. This is of the green variety. Now we're going to put soil on top, and I just put a little bit on each one, not a whole lot. Some people use Pearlite as a topper. We have used the soil, or potting soil, since we started, and we've never had an issue. So once I finish this, we're going to water them in, and then wait for them to germinate. All right, now we're going to water them in, and we just use a fine mist. They don't need that much water, because we made the blocks pretty wet. So basically you're just getting that top little bit of soil that you put on there wet, and they're good to go. So these will probably take 3 to 5 days for them to germinate, and we'll show you what that looks like. Hey y'all, it's been a week and we got good germination on the magenta, and the Nevada had a little bit of a rough time, but it has been a really hot week. So thank y'all for tuning in. If you like this video, like this video. If you want to subscribe, subscribe. And if you're already a subscriber, thank you so much.
The chair's squeaking.
Today we're also going to be filming